Five terms on the next one. Okay, it's a little bit tougher. So, but I'm un poco triste.
Here, I can get you to fill in, or you don't. Okay. So let's read through this definition.
we can they have a limit, we can add them, we can multiply them by a number, we can divide them. Alright, so we're gonna find the limit of the sequence if possible on this next part. Okay? So we're gonna basically find the limit of that as n approaches infinity, here's the calculus. There are two ways you can do this. Okay? Can't just plug in the infinity, right? We get infinity over 50, so what can we do? We do L'Hopital's rule. Okay? What else do we know? The coefficients, right? What do you notice about these guys? That's shorter than L'Hopital, if you can remember that. Okay? So, okay, because they're the same, we take the numbers in front and it is 8. If not, L'Hopital will get you there. Okay? Alright, so for the next one. Alright, so I'm gonna do the limit as n approaches infinity, 3 over n. Yeah, so what's my limit here? It's really just, could I have done L'Hopital? Sure. Okay. But if you look at just the pattern that we see there, you don't necessarily need L'Hopital. Because you're basically seeing that these guys are the same exponent, right? That's what it comes down to. The plus 5, when we get to infinity, is infinity. All right. Let's look at this next part. Did this say example 1 or does it keep going? Example 7. Alright, determine the convergence or divergence of the sequence with a given nth term. If the sequence converges, find its limit. So we're going to just look at the pattern of the sequence here. Okay, in fact, I think this is the first one we wrote down, isn't it? So we're looking to try to find the limit as approaches infinity at 3 plus negative 1 to the n. Now, when we wrote this sequence down before, what happened when we wrote out those terms? They switched back and forth, right? So was there really a determination of where it went? No. So this is something that diverges. We couldn't find the not necessarily. On that one I would have probably just used the numbers. But think about it. The other thing we could plug in is the infinity, right? Yeah, so from negative 1 to the infinity is going to go on forever. Yeah. We kind of need to. Alright, this one, I don't know if this is going to be difficult. Limit. As n approaches infinity, of n over 1 minus 2 to the n. I don't know why I'm doing equal sign there, I don't put equal sign in front of it, but I would just do that. Right. So let's think about the ways we could solve this. We could use the L'Hopital. Okay, do I have to? No. What's my exponent of both this?
1.
Okay, so what's my limit on this? As long as it doesn't go to infinity, it converges, right? And it would converge to that limit right there. So it converges to negative 1. Okay, so that's the Alright, we should be on about example 9, right? Okay. So, this one's a little bit uglier. This one's a lot uglier. Alright, so we're going to do the coordinate test, converges, diverges. We have to do that. Limit You get infinity squared over 2 to the infinity. Does that work for us?
No.
No. And I can't just look at my exponents this time because there is, it isn't just, they aren't the same exponent, right? One's a polynomial, one's an exponential. So I probably now do need to use a Hopi's whole square. Okay? So let's try this. So what's the derivative of the top? 2n. Okay? The one's going to go away, the bottom is the derivative of the one.
Sorry.
2 to the n, I like that part. Put a what in front of the 2? Nope. Nope. Hey, open up your count books. Look out for the derivative for the next step.
But just you.
No.
Oh, it's not e. 2n.
Look it up. It's an exponential. You gotta look it up. It's a to the u.
Right there, right there.
1 over delta.
Natural log of a.
Natural log of a times a to the u. Okay.
It's never.
All right. So. Is it okay to put the infinity in now? Does that work? Yes or no?
No,
it's still indeterminate, so what do I need to do again? Hopital. Typically, you have to keep the Hopital until you can get that variable out of the top. Okay? So what's the derivative of 2n? There are 2. Okay, we hopefully know this, but now the natural log of 2 is just going to hang out. It's the derivative of natural log of 2 to the n. Now I should be able to go ahead and put that infinity in there. Okay, so I've got 2 natural log of 2 times natural log of 2, or I guess I can do my square root of that, 2 to the infinity. So I've got 2 over, what's the denominator going to be? Infinity, which equals 0. So does it convert or divert? Converges. Yes. How did I get these natural logs? Okay, so are you looking in your book there?
Yeah.
Okay, so you need to look for the derivative under the derivative.
It's number 12.
12?
Yeah. Oh, what's the
name? Okay.
Got it.
Okay. Alright. We need to flip in your books to page 600. 600 in your books, please. 600. We're going to look up some definitions. Guess what? We're not going to get into it. Well, next school year. In August or September or October, whenever you start school. Depending upon some of you, you don't start till like the end of September. Alright, so page 600, I want you to look for the word monotonic. Okay. All right. We got a box, isn't it?
Yes.
You guys copy that definition right out of the book there. Monotonic.
Under this, grab that box.
Under that, we grab that box and copy it. It's not that big. Don't copy the second. Thank you. talk about just monotonic. Right? I'm not writing it down because you wrote it down out of your book. Right? So, it says a sequence is monotonic if its terms are non-decreasing, and then it gives you a bunch of less than symbols, right? If it's non-decreasing, what's happening? It's increasing. I don't know why they use the word non-decreasing. Well, it could, I guess non-decreasing could mean it because it said less than or equal to, right? So could it stay the same?
Yes.
Yes. It basically means it's kind of going one direction, not up and down, right? It's not alternating in any way. Or non-increasing meaning it is decreasing or staying the same. Okay. So let's look at bounded. Alright, and I'm going to help you abbreviate bounded a little bit, okay? So, says, look at error number one. Okay, so I'm reading on page 601 of the box. It says, definition of a bounded sequence. So a sequence is bounded above if there is a real number m such that a sub n is less than or equal to m for all n. The bounded number m is called the upper bound. Okay, so basically that's saying that there's no number bigger. Right, so let's write that down. We're going to have to write three things, right? There's one, two, three. All right, so here's my definition for bounded. Number one says that it is bounded above and it's basically in kindergarten words. I did not write that, but don't no number bigger. Alright. Number two says a sequence A sub n is bounded below if there is a real number n such that n is greater than or equal to A sub n, less than or equal to A sub n for all n, the number n is a lower bound of the sequence. So basically, if this one is bounded above, is no number bigger, what's the second one bounded below? No number smaller, good. Bounded below. So bounded monotonic sequence. If the sequence is bounded and monotonic, then what happens? What does it say? Then it converges. So it has to be bounded and monotonic to converge. Okay? Alright, so we're going to look at kind of that theorem and these definitions in the last three examples there. Okay, and then that's going to be it for today. Okay? Alright, so determine whether a sequence given the end term. kicked it out, right? They didn't ask us about that part, but alright, so we probably need to figure out so it's kind of built on what we did at the beginning of the lesson. We need to know what's happening with the sequence, right? So we've got to find all the terms. So A sub 1, A sub 2. Yeah, it's the same. Okay, so what you did on your own? All right, so what was our second one? direction. Alright. Is there a high number there? It's the biggest number we have. 1 1/3. It kind of goes up to 1 1/3 and then starts coming back down. We don't really maybe know the lowest number because it might, we could probably keep going, right?
Yeah.
We could say bounded above by 1 1/3. Bounded above. Alright, is there an example 13 in your notebooks?
Yeah.
Okay, apparently I don't have a type. So you have a sub n equals 1 over n. Alright, so go ahead and see how far you can get on that one. I'm going to give you a minute. Get it plugged in, see if you can figure out monotonic, bounded above, or bounded below.
This is the first video.
Okay. Keep in mind that this semester. Oh, sorry. Alright. This semester homework changes the way I do homework. Okay? So, for the first few weeks, probably the first about 6 weeks, it's the same as it was, right? Then as soon as we flip into the review for the AP test, I collect it every week. Okay? And there is no making it up. You start losing points every day instead of getting extra credit. Okay? So, you want to get make sure you're using some good habits and reinforcing some good habits, and I will help you with that. Probably have some random homework quizzes here and there. Okay? So I suggest doing your homework every day. Alright? So make sure you are keeping up. I think it will probably be about 4 weeks in, we'll probably take our first test. Okay? So, I mean, really got to finish the first half of chapter 9, got a little bit left of the second half, and then part of chapter 10. That's really kind of good. I break chapter 10 into kind of two parts. So, I'm hoping by the beginning of March we can be done.
Okay? David,